Yeah, balance is mostly good in against other creature decks to randomly fall behind and then catch back up. But in our deck, even if we make them get rid of their lands or their hand or whatever, we're having to sacrifice most of our creatures against him. So it really doesn't work out. Like the plan of get him to have no lands in play is good because we have some creatures around. Having one but not the other doesn't really work. Right, we have our opener here. It's not the best, but I'm gonna keep it. We might be able to get some value. Also, these other removals plus. Plus, we're just going to draw a creature right away, so it doesn't matter. He had Ancestral Recall and he did it main phase. So he had to discard. I don't agree with that. This is a pretty good draw. Now we definitely need a creature, what is this deck doing? So confused. Well, we drew a pretty good creature, and I guess I get to name Lion's Eye Diamond. I feel like I'm supposed to name Chandra. Where's my thing? But I think I'm just supposed to name this. To be honest, I'm pretty sure I'm just supposed to attack once and then skull clamp this thing away. So it doesn't really matter, but. Man of Holt. Chandra. Knew it. Okay, that's not bad. This is gonna deal damage to him. I can steal this. And move this here. If he wants to shoot it, feel free. Took two damage. Nope, just one. Frantic Search. I see. Why did you take a. Oh, because he needs double red for something. Oh, and he minus two, so he's double frantic searching. All right, so he's going off a little bit over here. Discard Awakening Zone Island. Discarded another island. That's three islands he's discarded and a Chrome Box, so this Ravages of War might be better than it's supposed to be. If he just casts a big creature here, that's fine. He had a Time Twister. Okay, I mean, I'm okay with that, I guess. He's refilling with a bunch of mana floating, but I get to draw three cards, so it's not the worst. More frantic searching. Pretty sure the play is just a bone shredder his guy. And then move Skull Clamp over to Bone Shredder. I totally tapped the worst way ever. Okay. Chandra down. Yes, I would like to draw two. Yes, I would like to discard. Discard, though. He's paying, so he's not going to do anything this turn. Or not much, at least. Yep, he's not doing anything. Well, I could just do this, I guess. Seems pretty good. And then we'll play this. Could have equipped Skull Clamp there, but I think playing this is slightly better. Gives me a second creature in case he answers either one. I'm not really sure what his deck's trying to do. He's got Oracle Madaya, Inkwell Leviathan, and the Mind's Desire is pretty scary. Alright, he's still in the tank. He's tapping stuff now. We'll see what he does at the end of all this. Oh, he casts Upheaval. I see. Science Adam doesn't seem like it's doing anything for him. He's willing to start taking damage to play a memory jar here. That feels weird. He's not going to memory jar now, is he? That would not make a ton of sense. So here I'm definitely discarding this guy. This. I wanted to keep this to get Soren out and stuff. I think I'll discard the path. He hasn't really shown any creatures, and I can ogreing them. I fully expect him to memory jar here. But then again, maybe not, because I only have 5 mana. Ancestral, really? Who keeps Ancestral? Like, why does... Like, he's just gonna discard 2 cards. So yeah, I think I just play the Relic Warder. I think I just attack and play Relic Warder, hitting that memory jar. I did this Chrome Box, to be honest. So next turn I could either play Sorin to lethal, make one of these guys lethal. Like let's say he kills Relic Warder here. I'm not too worried about him killing Relic Warder and then me not being able to mom it. That wasn't really a concern. Because if he does that, like if he kills this guy, he's not gonna have any mana to do anything with the turn. She's conceding. Alright, sweet. So that one's in the bag. We'll be back for round two, and I'll see you guys then.